Yep.
It's rolling, and it's Sunday the 24th of May. We're at the Sedgwick Hall, and we're interviewing Gerald Kavanagh. And this is for Rob Wilson for the National Library, because I don't think anybody has done anything much on drums. And I'll explain how this sort of came to mind. But years ago, with the Weathermen Old Timers, they were played regularly at the Weathermen Motel. They still do. There was a drummer running the motel, Kevin Simmons. Then he moved to Bendigo and he was teaching kids drums. He brought out a book and I said to him, it was all modern drumming, of course, and I said, oh, can you put anything in on the real old time style? And he said, oh no, that's all very well known. That wouldn't be needed. But my view is that today it is needed, because all the kids and everybody coming on are learning modern drumming, which is fine for things like rock and roll and Latin American and so on. But when it comes to doing an old-time dance, they don't know how to play that rhythm. And so that's what sort of got into my mind.
Yeah, well, that's actually what's happening too.
Yeah. So, Gerald, perhaps you could give a little bit of your family background and how you got into music, dancing, all of that.
Well, I was born in Warrnambool, and I came from a family of 13 children. I had 9 brothers and 3 sisters. I had one brother who played sax, and one sister who played violin and keyboard. I don't know why, probably because of the big dance that was down there in the Palais in Warrnambool, and there was a 12-piece band back in, I'm talking about 1944, and one of my friends I went to school with, he was a drummer, and I got interested in the drums, and I thought I'll learn these, and at the time I was driving, there was no trucks in those days, of course, and we weren't earning much money, but 27 and sixpence a week, and giving my mother a pound and 7 and 6 to play with, which I played my drum lessons with. And I learned from a chap that played in the Trocadero in Sydney. He was a Palais drummer in those days and a very, very good drummer. And I learned from him and just went on from there and got playing around Warrnambool with the Hartleys and a few other people, Ted Trotter and Nell Manuals and Hilda Gabe, all pianists and bass players in the old time bands, and they had a boomerang club dance that every Saturday night in Warrnambool at the Temperance Hall. And the boomerang club used to play there, and I got a job with that band there firstly. And then I was about 17 then, I think. And eventually it was my ambition to get to the Palais to play, which I did. Played there for a few years in the Palais, and then had to give it up because when I was about 22, gave up drumming because it was interfered with my work as an auctioneer and with livestock. And I didn't have the time then, was travelling a fair bit, so I gave it up then for about, well, I suppose, 20 years, and took it up again when I came to Bendigo and was fortunate enough to get work with the Amy Creek Band, which I appreciate very much, and it's just been my ambition to play both with this class of music and for the old-time dancers we play for Spring Gully. I've got my own band there called Millionaires, got nothing to do with money, it's a million tunes. And I play with them twice a month, and with Amy Creek once a month, and I was quite recently played with the dancing pennies with Don and Julie Manypeney, which I enjoyed immensely, and hope to be able to do it for a lot longer.
And just while we're on the introductory bit, but what year were you born, Gerald?
1928.
1928. And you've played with groups other than dance bands, haven't you? You've done some work with the...
Oh yes, I've played at the theatre with Terry Carr and Doug Gray, Brian Thomas, and in the pit there for all the pantomimes that they used to play and used to run, and with the Lindy shows.
Yeah.
We played at the Capitol Theatre for quite some years, and that was one of the reasons how we got the dance band together called the Millionaires, and then took on the dancing.
Right. Mm. Now, I'm going to start with a quick step or a fast foxtrot, and we'll just see what sort of a rhythm you play. We're basically playing in 2-4 or cut common time, I'm not sure which, but anyway, we'll get a bit of an idea of the sort of style we use.
Right.
Thank you.
set tune at the same time or not, but I'll play a set tune a couple of times and then go into a jig.
Okay.
Thank you.
that sort of stuff. It's quite common with old time bands.
Long as I've done very well too.
The waltzes.
Right. I love the waltzes.
And you love the catalpa, so we'll start with
that. Yeah, particularly the lovely old tune. I love those old ones.
So this would be, maybe I should do a circular first, which is just a little bit slower. Now, Harry McQueen always maintained Merry Widow is a good one for the circular.
Right. Yeah, that's steady.
Thank you.
through in a set tune following the catalpa. Well, the old timers used to use the catalpa for Pride of Erin.
Oh, right, okay.
And then I threw in the Spanish waltz, which we use in the Alberts and the Constitution. Modern waltz, Gerald.
Modern waltz, yes, we can.
You want your brushes for that?
You want the modern waltz brushes. I've got my metronome over the counter, I want to start at 30.
Oh,
what are you going to play?
I think in the Valley of the Moon. Now, the gringos know this is the jazz waltz, but we Mexicans call it the modern waltz.
Right.
Something.
I thought you get that down at the bottom, but you're right.
Anyway, we'll move across to Tangawet, which is really what a begin or a habanero rhythm is.
Yeah,
isn't
yeah.
Right. Lady of Spain will do. That's Daisy's tune. Daisy Sutton used to say it had to be played lively enough that your feet were in the air more than they're on the floor. Or it would hurt your knees. Now, if you're playing some parts of New South Wales and Queensland, they play what they call the mazurka. And it's the same music, but it's a lot, it's circular waltz tempo. And they don't have the polka step too, it's a waltz turn. And I'll just use the same tune just a little bit, but that would be more.
Thank you.
academic from, but it's part of the Rainbow Shalish, which is in music. And I think the old Shalishes have got, there's a bit of bounce in the tune.
Beautiful. Yeah. It really is. Made to play.
Yeah.
And there are tunes that do that.
Trevor Holden, and the barn dance is sort of the same music. Now, the old barn dance, not the progressive, which has got the kick in it, he always maintained that All By Yourself and the Moonlight emphasised that, and I'll probably demonstrate that in a minute.
Yeah.
I'll play it.
I can feel that.
Yeah.
All By Yourself and the Moonlight.
Yeah.
Seems rather quick to me.
Yeah, well, it might be. Was I too quick for it?
Four minutes.